So who am I speaking with?
I'm Marshall Kirkpatrick, co-editor of ReadWriteWeb.
And Marshall, do you advocate brands? If so, which ones and why?
I do. When I find a good tool on the internet that I can use for work, I get real excited about it and I tell as many people as I possibly can. One of my favorites is a service called Needlebase, which is a product built by ITA Software, soon to be a Google property. And it is a point-and-click DIY database creation tool that you can use to scrape data off of pages and then merge that data, visualize it in different formats, put it in a spreadsheet, build benchmarks, all kinds of stuff. If there's structured data on the web, you can scrape it with Needlebase, work some magic with it, and find the stories that are lurking in the data.
That does sound like a great product, because the need to scrape data is actually a constant issue. Well then, you say you tell all your friends about it, how do you actually go about doing that?
I load it up and I show people some of the most accessible examples of ways that I've used it, and I like telling stories, so I tell stories about the most enjoyable, fruitful, and clearly comprehensible times that I've used that tool myself.
So tell me quickly one story that you used that saved your ass.
So, Salt Lake City newspaper some time ago ran a story saying there's a big new data center in Salt Lake City with a mystery anchor client, and we think that it's Twitter. So I went and used Needlebase and scraped the tweets from all of the Twitter staff members, the 2,500 most recent tweets, and I said, grab the message, the username, and the location if they've been exposed, then map it. And there was one tweet that showed up on the map in Salt Lake City from a network engineer that said, I've left San Francisco, arrived in Salt Lake City, and I'm ready to get started. And I said, there we go. I think there might be some truth to that report.